And like Mr. Fox said, everybody didn't make the men comfortable, you missed it. Our thing was what happened with God, we put men put God first. So I tried to do a form around that topic. So when men put God first, as his word commands us to, our minds will be transformed and renewed, and God's will we will do. When men put God first, they become better husbands, fathers, brothers, and friends. Men of faith, trust, integrity, ones on whom you can depend. By putting God first, a man will realize he's not his own, but he's been bought with the price, and that the blood of Jesus can break the strongholds that Satan has upon his life. By putting God first, a man's will become null and void. He will no longer lean to his own understanding, but he will trust in the Lord. He will no longer look to his own things, but on the things of others, as God's word teaches him to love, respect, pray for, intercede for his sisters and his brothers. He will allow the word of God to have free course in his life, allowing the Holy Spirit through him to lead souls to Jesus Christ. He will no longer be conformed to this world, but his affection will be set on things above. He will learn to dwell in the secret place of the Most High, abiding in God's love. When a man put God first, God becomes his light and salvation. There's no one to fear. His truth shall be a shield and buckler, a very present help in a time of trouble. He's always near. By putting God first, his word will become man's daily delight. It will purge him from worldly lust and an ungodly appetite. When men put God first concerning the gospel, they will not be ashamed. With the Holy Ghost boldness to a dying world, the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, we will proclaim. Woo!